guys, this is Sakshi and I heartily welcome you all to Books with Sakshi. I really hope that you all are doing great. Today's video is actually a collaboration video with one of the book bloggers, and it's going to be super amazing because we people are going to recommend you three books. I'm going to recommend you three books, and the other person who is in collaboration with me is going to recommend you three books. So total you have like six books. They are like the must read books, but definitely at the end of the day it's your choice what you have to read, but these books are really great ones, so watch this video until the very end. Oh, I forgot to mention one important thing. The person with I'm collaborating is a book blogger and her name is Gudiya. I'm going to link her channel in the description below so you can check out her channel as well. So without wasting time, let's get started.
Hello everyone. So the very first recommendation of mine will be The Namesake by Jhumpa Lahiri. It's a lovely story underpinning cultural, emotional and ideological conflicts of a Bengali couple who moved to America post their marriage. The story is about a young couple named Ashok Ganguly and Ashima Ganguly and their children Gogol, aka Nikhil and Sonia. Moving out of your native place and accepting and assimilating in an altogether new culture is a challenging job, and failing in accepting those challenges is yet another challenge, and more so when there is a generation gap. Gogol doesn't like his name, and this ultimately reflects the cultural conflicts in the further plot. Later on, he comes to the realization that a person's name doesn't reflect or state one's identity. The way this book has been written is the star factor for me, and I would strongly recommend this piece to each one of you. Go and give this book a read. My second recommendation would be the 1997 Booker Prize winner, The God of Small Things by Arundhati Roy. This is a masterpiece, and it surrounded a lot of controversies when it got circulated to the masses for all the possible reasons. This story basically puts forth a simple question before the reader: who should be loved and how much? This book is exceptional, and this becomes more so imperative when you get to see the extreme tastes of people in regards to this book. Either you love this book a lot or you hate it completely. At least I think that there is no moderate opinion in this respect. The story is set in a small village of Kerala where lives a very wealthy and a prosperous family, and the different types of events which take place in that family narrate the underlying theme of casteism, communism and different social ideals and beliefs which can maneuver a person's feelings, instincts, emotions. The story narrates the childhood experiences of a fraternal twins whose lives are destroyed by the love laws which lay down the notion that who should be loved and how. This piece, I believe, is one of the best pieces of literature, and you ought to give this piece a read for once at least. The book, however, is not an easy breezy read. It's a hard-boiled tale, and you will require to delve deep into it to understand or to seize the plot or to decipher the underlined and hidden themes. The third and the last recommendation would be Ladies Coupe by Anita Nair. It is a harrowing narrative revolving around the lives of six women, each having a different story to tell, but a very common and customary theme on which their issues are set. Through the fair portrayal of six women, Akhila being the central or the main character, Anita Nair addresses the complexities and contortions which were quite evident and ahead of that time. The basic premise of the story is set on a very simple yet a very powerful and a gripping question: can a woman live on her own? The novel also raises questions on a lot of social evils, and you ought to give this piece a read without giving a second thought.
So the very first recommendation which I have for you people is The Silent Patient. It's a psychological thriller, and it's truly an amazing psychological thriller. It's about a woman named Alicia who actually kills her husband Gabriel. After that, she completely becomes silent. No one can make her speak, and that is the best part about this book, that even though so many people try to make her speak, still she does not speak. Theo is a psychotherapist who feels that only he can make Alicia speak. Why he feels so? You will find this in the book. This is truly an unputdownable psychological thriller. I agree the book is slow paced initially, but once it picks the speed, it is truly unputdownable. So if you're someone who really likes to read psychological thrillers, definitely you should be checking out on this book as soon as possible. Next recommendation which I have is The 40 Rules of Love by Elif Shafak. I finished this recently, and first of all, this book is not a beginner's friendly book. This book is quite difficult in terms of language. It's the most beautiful book I read in 2020. It is about self-love, self-discovery, about love beyond the definition of love, and it is about Sufism, about Rumi, Shams, and there is so much about the history of Islam. Like, it won't bore you at all because all of these things are beautifully covered in the form of this fiction that you will just enjoy. You will truly understand the meaning of love. You will truly understand the meaning of self-love. You will accept yourself the way you are. You will find time for yourself. It is about all these things. It is a great fiction, the most beautiful fiction I read in 2020, and I highly recommend it to everyone. Last but not the least, the third recommendation I have is A Thousand Splendid Suns by Carl Dosani. Why this book? Because this book will definitely teach you that no matter how many problems are there in your life, there's always a way to come out of it. And people who know about Carl Dosani, they definitely know that how his books are so emotional, so much in depth that you are definitely going to cry. But I can promise you one thing, that the ending of this book is not going to make you cry. Even the ending of The Kite Runner was not something to cry over. It was definitely inspiring, like, but here and there you're going to cry definitely, because oh my god, this is so beautiful. Carl Dosani is my most favorite author, honey. Writes so beautifully. The ending is definitely of this book as well is going to be so inspiring. So definitely go and check out this book if you have not read it yet. And so these were the recommendations. I really hope that you enjoyed this video. You found something, at least one book for yourself, and you're definitely going to read that for you. And so that was it. It was very fun collaborating with Guria to make this video, because we really wanted to bring something good, helpful for you people. So that's it. I really hope you enjoyed. And if you like this video, please give this video a thumbs up. If you're new to my channel, please consider subscribing to my channel. I post videos every Thursday and Sunday. And in case you're not following me on Instagram, kindly go and follow me on my Instagram with the handle @booksofsakshi. I'll see you in the next video. Until next time, take care.